Welcome to another Coffee Tech Break session, your place to be for the latest and greatest on the Poly products. Now, in my last sessions, I talked you through the Teams Room devices, Zoom Room devices. Hopefully that was useful for your adventure looking for the right room and what device you need where. Specifically, I got a lot of questions about Ego Direct 2, a really enhanced camera with a lot of technology inside. So, about the room setup, lighting, how to install the inputs and outputs, etc. I got a lot of questions about it. So, I thought, let me specifically take a coffee tech break session to talk you through this camera. First of all, I will talk you through the different components and then I will take you through a presentation to give you some guidelines, show you some different devices to connect it up to and other things. Now, how about the components? First of all, we got the base, the Ego Director base. There's a room view camera. That is a very important, which always gives you a room view in a sort of pip. And we got microphones in here. Just like here in this tower, we got microphones. It has two cameras. These are the Eagle Eye 4 12 times zoom. That's very important. So we got two of them. Now, what's happening is the microphones inside in combination with speaker track and we'll go to the different speakers in the room. So if you got multiple speakers, one camera will go to the first speaker and then the other camera will look for the second speaker. And then you got a sort of CNN transition between the speakers. It's really, really nice. And as it is a 12 times optical zoom, you can really do rooms up to 10 meters, but I will show you that in a presentation. Now, let me take you through the different scenarios after a coffee. Now, this is really an enhanced camera. So the Ego Director 2 for your bigger rooms can give the remote speakers a very nice impression of the room. So you can have an Ego Director 2 front, and the Ego Director 2 in combination on the side and hook them up to each other. Same is, for example, for a big auditorium, more in the educational world, very powerful. But also in meeting rooms. If you got regular meeting rooms, long tables, Ego Director 2 here at the top can also give the users a really, really good view on the other side. So you don't have to touch any presets. It's all doing the automatic tracking itself. And I think that's very powerful. Looking at the room requirements, because I think that's very important. First of all, 10 meters up to the last chair in the room, the last speaker here. And 10 meters is what seems to be fair looking at the 12 times optical zoom. Now, if it can't find speaker, it will give you a room view. And so I think that's very important. The rule is always, cannot find the speaker or something, just show me a room view. And of course, as soon as it can find the speaker again, it will move to that speaker and zoom in. Now, so you can have a Ego Director 2 here at the front. You can use that or also in combination with Director 2 on the side to give you best impression of the speaker. Same in this setup, so you can put it here on one side to show these speakers and on the other side, which will show these speakers. There's all kinds of different scenarios possible. These are just a couple of examples. Also in a sort of auditorium setup, again, make sure it's a 10 meter range to the last chair. But that's with optical zoom, I think very, very powerful. Now, if we look at the different hardware, the I/O of the Director 2, it's got all kinds of different connectors. So first of all, the HDCI out. This is the connector if you use it in combination with Visual Pro or Group Series. Here we got HDMI in and HDMI out. that is the combination when you use it, for example, with a Teams room system. So it can pick up automatically the audio. I will show you that a bit later, as I got all kinds of different architecture drawings to walk you through. We got the USB port. This is, it's going to your Teams room system. And the Polycom, the G-series, or you can even hook it up to your laptop. That's also a possibility. So this is this one. You got here an USB input. This is more with a USB stick. So in case you want to do a local software update, that's also possible. You can force that through this port, so you can put in a USB stick. I got some other videos showing you those updates, that is also a possibility. Now, updates can also go through Windows Update Services. So in case you hook it up to a Teams Room device, updates can also go through USB port, or in case you use it through HDCI with the Visual Pro Group Series, same thing, it will get software updates through here. Now, further, we got a LAN, and this is where you can hook up a secondary EcoDirector to on the other side of the room. It can be a direct cable or it can go through a network. We got 3.5 millimeter audio in. This is to do the remote speaker cancellation. So in case you use it with the, for example, Visual Pro and Group Series, so you can pick up the audio output and inject that here through the 3.5 millimeter. So it's able to identify the remote speaker and filter that that audio. And of course, we have the power. So these are the inputs and outputs of the Director 2. Now, let's look at the range, because I think that's also important for your specific rooms. Now, as the tracking, this has a range of 150 degrees. So I think that's very powerful. You can go up to 150 degrees, 10 meters, as you see here. So even when a speaker is completely on the side of that room, at the front, it's able to track him up that degree. And also here you see the PIP, which has an 80 degree room view, so that usually should be sufficient when you got here a long table and to give everybody everybody in the view as a general overview if everybody is there. And so you can turn it off, or you can put the PIP on another location if you want, or the laptop, or you can customize that. And that is all possible. Now, looking at the lightning requirements. First of all, make sure you're above 500 lux. That means office light. Good office light. Bright office light. I think that's very important. Including the color. 3700 Kelvin should be sufficient. That's a sort of morning light and not too warm and not too cold. It's a little bit in between. 3700 should be fine. This is important. This will give you, especially lightning, as it's able to track voice, but it also will track your face. So you need to have proper lightning, not lights behind speaker. Be aware, because if you go from behind, then the lens will close, so it will give you less quality, and the image will dark. So make sure that speaker is not behind a window or something. There's all kinds of things which can make the experience a lot better. So be aware of all those scenarios. Now, if you look at the tracking up and down, you can have 5 degree up, and you can go a minus 15 degree down. And I think that's all good to know. But an average, it's really can give you a good overview of the room. Now, some install tips, because that is also good to know for the integrators. So what is delivered with the Director 2 is a wall plate. And that's usually the best. So here you see all the measurements of the wall plate. You can also find them in the setup sheet there if you go to the support site. But I got it here summarized. So this is handy if you want to integrate it into a cupboard or something. make sure it's between 1.7 and 2.1 meters high to get a good overview of the room, and also to have some space around it. So 0.2 meters at least space between the director two and maybe a wall or a ceiling, etc. It needs to have some space to do the proper tracking with the mics built into the director two. That is important. Now, where I also get a lot of questions, as you can use the director two using USB or HDCI, what extenders can we use? Now, these are all well documented in the release notes, but I know not everybody is able to find them, but you can find them in the release notes. So we tested the Icon Ranger. So that is good to know. If you need to extend USB, you can go up to 100 meters and you bring USB to Cat 5e or higher, and you can easily extend that cable. Now, the whole package is around 4K. For kilogram, so that is to make sure that it it can, if you make a wall plate or something, you can it's able to hold the weight. Cables can go here to that wall mount, and so there's also kind of holes in the wall mount to nicely let the cables here flow through it. What is also good to know is the extenders is the digital extenders for HDCI. So besides the USB, there's also an HDCI extender. So that's specifically for Visio Pro and for Group Series. There's also a 100 meter extender available. And this can come from Poly. And we have that available. The same is if you want a breakout to, for example, HDCI. And so we also have that option available. So you can go from HDCI into HDMI with a serial controller. So if you want to integrate this into rooms, etc., that could be a possibility. How about current rooms? So let's say you're using today, for example, the Eagle Eye 4 4x zoom, or you use the Eagle Eye 12 4x zoom. Well, these are the same as we use in the director 2. So if you order the whole package, these are the 12x zoom cameras. But in case you already have some of those cameras, or even the Eagle Eye for the 4x zoom, you can use that in the base of the director 2. Of course, be aware, if you use the Eagle Eye 4 and use it with 4x zoom, you won't be able to reach 10 meters as the optical zoom is limited to 4x. But you can use the auto tracking, speaker track, group track functionality, etc. So you can buy Poly the base only and reuse those cameras. And I think that's very powerful. So then you got the option to break out to USB, and you can have the option to break out to HDCI. Now, let me give you some examples. So here you see an example where you have a couple of Eagle Eye 4 4x zooms, a couple of Eagle Eye 4 12x zooms with Group Series, Visio Pro, Trios. Now, here you see an example. Let's say you move to zoom. So the G7500, you can move that device into native zoom. Now, of course, you can hook up Eagle Eye 4 directly into the G7500 using the HDCI and also the 4x zoom. That's a possibility. But in case you want to enhance the room move to some bigger rooms, and you don't want to do that presets or pan tilt zoom, no, you want to have automatic speaker track and group track, then you just buy the Eagle Director 2 base and you can use two of the same cameras, so two of the 4x or two of the 12x in the base, and you got that functionality. You can HDCI connect that to the G7500 and you're ready to go. And also, of course, you can use your 8500 and 8800, put that in the zoom room controller mode, and then you can also pair that up as a controller on the table. So it's really really some powerful migrations which you can do with your current setup. Same is when you move to native Teams. So when you move to a native Teams device, it needs to be USB enabled. Now, the Eagle Eye cameras doesn't have a USB connector. But again, what you can do is you can reuse those cameras, put them in the base of the Director 2, and then suddenly you got your USB connector in your Teams room device. And in this case, in the new Poly G series, which is the Teams room compute, and hook that up as a camera. And not only as a camera, but you got this enhanced functionality for your bigger rooms. So you can do that speaker track and group track. And same for the Trio. You put that in the USB mode, and also you can hook it up to that GC8 on the table, and you're ready to go. So you can reuse a lot of those devices in your new setup. Now, let us look at an example. So how does a room look like with all those components? And then I will talk you through the different architecture for the room. So how is everything connected? So first of all, you got your Director 2. Here, for example, on top of a service hub. Top of service hub, or like I said, a Teams room system, etc. Now, this one is connected to the service hub using USB. And we have the Trio here on the table in USB mode, which is also connected to the service hub for the speaker and mic. And of course, you got some controls on the Trio. Now, we can even add a secondary Director 2. And the nice thing is, this one can be directly connected here, for example, over the ceiling from the primary. You can use this from a network if you want. It only needs a power and a secondary and that cable. All the configuration will come from the primary. So as soon as you pair those devices, the Eco Director 2, and you make them master and slave, all the configuration, the secondary, will be synced. So here you see a sort of example, but let me now talk you through the cabling. So how does this look like? First of all, Director 2. So this guy is hooked up using USB. Very, very simple. And of course, the other cable is the power that's here on the back. Now, we see here the USB cable from the Trio. And that's also important for the speaker and mic functionality. And make sure you got power over Ethernet. So with the LAN, make sure that the Trio has the power. And I'm using here a C60, but again, you can also use the 85 or the 8800. Now, what is important is the far-end echo cancellation. So you can pair the Eco Director 2 with the Trio on the table to make sure that when the audio comes here out of the Trio, that Director 2 is aware that that is a remote speaker, and he doesn't have to use the tracking on that. So that pairing will be used over the network. I think that's very, very powerful. And I'll show you a bit later how you can pair Director 2 with the Trio. It's the same pairing as you do with Trio and a Visual Plus or a Visual Pro, but I will show you that. Next example is, let's say you're going for the G80 bundle. So that's a brand new bundle which supplies you with the compute, a GC8 on the table for the control. You got the C60 for the speaker and mic functionality and the Eco Director 2. So how do you connect all those devices in the room? So first of all, got GC8 on the table. You hook up the Trio using a USB cable. You got your HDMI cable for a computer walking in and wants to share content. Now, there's one cable, that fiber USB cable. Standard cable is coming with the G80 package, the 10 meters cable, but you got different options there. Now, what is important? You got the USB cable going from that Director 2 into the compute. And the HDMI output here onto the screen. Very, very easy and clean. And here you do the same pairing. So over the network, you create a pairing between the C60 and the camera. That is again the far end echo cancellation. So you pair them up over the network and the tracking will avoid the audio coming from the trio and to do the tracking on that. Now, in my next design, what I wanted to show you is with an external speaker. So in case, for example, you got the G10 bundle and you might be reusing one of your EUI directors, but you got already a mic on the table and you're using a soundbar in this case as the audio output. So what you then need to do is you can route the HDMI out from the compute here through the EUI director 2 and then route that to the screen. And you see that right here. So you got your HDMI in, your HDMI out, and that is the possibility for the director 2 to capture that audio and do that far end echo cancellation. And so all the sound coming here through this bar will not be used by the tracking functionality of the EUI director 2. Now, the last setup which I wanted to show you is the combination the EUI director 2 with the G7500. And in this case, in the zoom room mode. So you got or a TC8 or a C60 at the table. C60 combines audio speaker and a mic, or you use the 8500 and 8800. Now, G7500 is connected using HDCI to the EUI director 2. And you need to use the 3.5 millimeter output of the G7500 into the EUI director 2. Again, in that case, the EUI director 2 is then aware of the audio from the remote speaker and to do that far end echo cancellation. And of course, you got your screen output here to the screen, which, by the way, can also be a touchscreen. And then we have another cable, which is the USB cable for the control. Now, how do we pair a trio and an EUI director 2 with each other? Now, you need to go to the advanced settings and then to network devices. Here, you need to create a filter and you search specifically for camera. Now, they should be both in the same network because otherwise not able to find each other. Now, if you then look under available devices, you will see that a director 2 is detected and then you click on it and you can pair it. So it's very, very easy. It's similar as you connect the Visual Plus and the Visual Pro. And then the EUI director 2 will be able to filter that far end audio. Now, lastly, what is I think important if, because I didn't walk that through in this video, as I always try to keep it as short as a coffee break, I have other videos showing you how to configure those two director 2s in the room and how to pair them up. And so if you want to review these, just search on my channel for EUI director 2 or Cascade and you're able to find that video. Here ends the coffee tech break session for today. Hopefully the information about the EUI director 2 was useful for your own environment. I always recommend to get in contact with your local AV integrator, involve your poly sales engineer, and review your rooms.